The coronavirus pandemic has struck more than 200 countries and territories around the world. Ireland is one of them. It's trying to keep the contagion from spiralling out of control with a stay-at-home order until April 12th. Johns Hopkins University says the country has more than 2,400 cases and 36 deaths, including 14 fatalities on Saturday. Well, Stephen McDonald is recovering from COVID-19 after spending more than 2 weeks in a Dublin hospital. He says there were many moments when he didn't think he'd make it.
For the first 10 days, I didn't sleep at all, hardly yet. Just the same day over and over again with high temperatures, a hacking cough. It was quite horrific, actually. Kept thinking I was going to die. I came close to ICU. I had a blood transfusion. But the last few days now, I've really pulled through.
Well, Stephen McDonald joins us now from Dublin to tell us more about what it's like to live through this horrific illness. Stephen, great to have you with us, and thank you for joining us. Tell us, why didn't you think you were going to make it?
It was the same day over and over again. I had about 10 days of like 102, 104 degree temperatures, just day after day. And at some stage, your brain is saying, you can't keep doing this. And you're waiting for a heart attack or something. It's you just feel you just can't just keep doing this over and over again. It was so, so difficult.
So what was the worst moment for you?
Don't be too graphic, but the worst moment was about 12 days in. I got a projectile vomiting and diarrhea and a 104 degree temperature. And at that stage, I thought I was dying.
And tell me if we can go back about you contracting the virus. Tell us about that when the alarm bells went off.
I was the fittest guy I knew. I was training for a half marathon. I was training five times a week. And I developed a tiny little cough. And after about 4 days, that turned into fevers and chills and a more severe hacking cough. And then I start getting really bad night sweats. So I put myself into self-isolation. I rang the health service. They didn't deem me fit to be tested.
Why is that?
But after, at the time they had said, because I hadn't evidence of being in contact with somebody who was contaminated, they didn't deem I needed to be tested, even though I had a 104 degree temperature. I rang my GP. My GP got me to A&E. I got into A&E, and within an hour into A&E, I was in isolation. Within 3 hours, they had X-rayed me and told me I had a viral pneumonia. And within 24 hours, they told me I had COVID-19 and viral pneumonia. And I was in isolation then for 16 days.
16 days.
Pretty tough. It's mentally, it was very, very difficult. I do have to call it. I made that little video purely because I wanted to call out the nursing frontline staff in the hospital. I've never been in hospital before. I've never been ill. And when you're a middle-aged man crying on the bed, thinking you're going to die, and you have these nurses around you holding your shoulders, telling you everything's going to be okay, doing everything they can for you, I had to put a little video together just to say thank you to those frontline staff. They were incredible. They were truly, truly incredible.
Yeah, these people are extraordinary, aren't they? They're sacrificing their lives, putting themselves at risk to save people like you. Stephen, what would be your advice to somebody who is currently dealing with COVID-19? What's your advice to them?
Well, I suppose, and talking to the nurses in the hospital as well, is that it will pass. I mean, as long as you don't have an underlying condition that's gonna cause further complications, but it will pass. And it seems that what happened to me, those kind of 10 to 12 days of the repetitive high temperatures and lack of sleep seems to be quite mm-hmm. common. So not to lose hope or not to lose faith in that you will get through it. Again, once you broke the kind of the 12-day barrier, since then I've been gradually getting better. I'm still feeling very weak. I'm still feeling very, very tired. I'm struggling to breathe a lot still. But once you get through the 12-day barrier, it seems to be okay after that.
Well, Stephen McDonald, it is fantastic to have you with us. We wish you the very best and a full recovery. Thanks so much.
Thank you, Anna.